This is All India Radio, Calicut. Good evening, listeners, and welcome back once again to yet another edition of our English program. Between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. on any given day, Dr. Prathap Somnath wears many hats. A top-notch surgeon who heads the pediatric surgery department at Calicut Medical College, this Perunthachan also teaches the fine art of surgery to medical students and then moves on to the hot seat of the vice principal of Calicut Medical College. Woo! Dr. Prathap Somnath has written surgery textbooks and has also brought out a handbook on pediatric surgery. A compulsive diary writer, not a day passes for him without an entry in his folio. How, pray, does he manage to juggle all these and more in any given day without blowing his top?
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
While regular yoga and cardio workouts are a must for this good doctor, for his soul, he immerses himself wholly into music.
We are the champions of the world.
Freaking out over his favorite Tama jazz drum set with gay abandon is indeed a catharsis for his soul, admits Dr. Prathap.
18 till I die, kill me forever, this wishful thinking. Whoever said that must be drinking.
Sampling delicious morsels from the offerings of Backstreet Boys to the classics of Vailar Devarajan soaks up the stress, leaving him a free bird. So music verily is indeed his path to nirvana. So here's Dr. Prathap Somnath on a song, blowing his horn like a jazz trumpeter on the topic.
Music, medicine for the soul. Sir William Shakespeare had once remarked in the play The Twelfth Night that if music be the food of love, play on. The origin of music dates some 60,000 years back to the prehistoric era, the age of the Neanderthal man, when a flute-like instrument was created by making holes in a bear's femur, that is the thigh bone. This was identified in a cave at Slovenia. During early times, music was also created by clapping or beating hands on different surfaces, and was meant to convey messages, to identify like-minded people, and also in an urge to be in tune with the sounds of nature. As society evolved, so did music. The Western world started with church music, prayers, instrumentals, and later romantics and others. Indian music also dates some 30,000 years back, as evidenced in a cave in Madhya Pradesh. Indus Valley civilization also throws light into the popularity of music during those times. In the Vedas, music was used as an offering to God. Later, music evolved to patriotic songs, classicals, romantics, etc. Hindu mythology clearly mentioned how Lord Krishna used a flute to herd the cows. Our kings used to entertain court musicians in palaces and keep them in good stead. As a doctor, I find music useful to elevate the mood of chronic bedridden patients. It helps in early recovery of head injury patients, healing of burns, and soothing of cancer patients. It hastens the recovery of depression and other mental disorders by calming an agitated mind. It can be used as an important therapeutic tool in de-addiction centers. Music makes the life worth living for old destitutes and orphans. Literally, it mends broken hearts. As a pediatric surgeon, I find that a soothing low-volume background music brightens up and lightens the tense atmosphere in the operation theater, alleviating the anxiety of those children wheeled in for major surgeries or even minor painful procedures. It's a given that Down syndrome children are music lovers, and this acts as a blessing because it takes a major chunk of the strain from the caregivers who look after them. As a general rule, music is a stress buster in a stressful life and also a panacea for boredom. On a personal front, my present job is quite a demanding one as a professor and head of the Super Speciality Department of Pediatric Surgery and also as the Vice Principal of Government Medical College, Kozhikode. I have to treat patients, perform surgeries on children, take classes for medical personnel like undergraduates, postgraduates and postdoctorals, do administrative work as head of the department and do additional administrative work also as the Vice Principal. The only thing which helps me to maintain my sanity is listening to music, singing songs and practicing and performing jazz drums. On returning home after a hectic day at the hospital, college and office, I switch myself on to music. Then I can feel the flow of positive hormones in my system, which cleanses the buildup of negativity of the long day. I can feel music percolating through the knotted nerve strands and rusted joint hinges as a soothing viscous nectar, smoothing the sharp edges of my various organ systems, giving rise to goose pimples and finally pacifying the body and the mind in toto. An earnest appeal to the great singers and judges. There is a general trend among judges to expect a true mimicry of the original song when a newbie is singing, which makes them hypercritical, thereby putting the youngsters off. I, for one, firmly believe that music is an art which can be created from virtually nothing, but both vocally or with instruments. And hence, there can be variations in its expressions. Just as there are different ways of performing surgery for the same disease by different surgeons, provided you stick to the basics, of course. Or different ways of driving, teaching, tailoring, painting, cooking, or for that matter, doing any artistic act. Every human being is unique, and a complete mimicry of the original song loses the uniqueness or signature of the person who is singing. So, promote the freshers, let's enjoy with them the music in all its varied forms. So, more than Shakespeare's food of love, soulful music is indeed a medicine for the soul.
I've paid my dues, time after time. I've done my sentence, but committed no crime. And bad mistakes, I've made a few.
Now that was Dr. Prathap Somnath, Vice Principal of Calicut Medical College, waxing eloquent on the topic, Music, Medicine for the Soul. Let me sincerely hope that you found his insights so very enlightening. We are now coming to the end of our very, very special English radio show. We'll be back on air Sunday next. Goodbye till then. Good night.